Look at this scene. Is this incredible? This is Connemara, Pennsylvania, and we caught Norfolk Southern pulling a tanker train over the Connemara River, over a long trestle, which is over a stone arch viaduct. And it's winter time, and the sun's out, and it was warm enough to fly the drone. And it's my first time here, and I thought, what an incredible scene, and that gave me the inspiration to make this video. Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube. Very often I get emails and messages about people that are starting their first layout or just getting into the hobby, and they say, I don't know what to model. And here's a thought. Pick a scene that inspires you and start with that scene. Even if you have a giant oval of track, maybe just a giant loop, have one scene that you'll be proud of, something that's going to get your attention, something that you want to see when you walk into the train room or wherever your railroad's going to be at. Look at this. Think about this. Think about seeing, even if you had a simple oval, but at the end the track goes around a curve through a mountain and then off into staging or off the layout or something. There's just so many possibilities. Everything in this scene you can make easier than you think. The bridge that you see, that's pretty easy. That's a Cotto truss bridge. And I've done videos about how to take this bridge from Cotto, take it apart, flip it over, and make it exactly like the bridge in the video. It's one of the first videos I ever did. So let's see, what else do we have in this scene? Oh yeah, the piers. Now personally, I like to make my own bridge piers. You can make them any height instead of trying to find the right one at the store. So to make bridge piers, I made a video long time ago on how to scratch build your own bridge piers. That's just styrene, and it looks great. So what else do we see in this video? Oh, okay, the stone arch viaduct. Well, that's an easy one. You can simply use one from Atlas. They make a viaduct, and you can custom make it for your own size. And what else? Oh, well, of course, I've done so many videos over the years of rivers. We're not going to cover the dam, though. But still, I made a river with a retaining wall, and you can make your own dam. But this is an easy-to-follow video. And let's see, what else? Well, I know a lot of people say, well, you know, I can make the bridge like you said, and I just don't know how to paint it and rust it to make it look like it does here. Well, really, painting and rusting, I like to take prototype photos and videos like this and then match it. And it's so easy to do it with $1 acrylic paints and with these cosmetic foam sponges. It's my favorite technique, and you can weather anything and make it look just like that. And don't forget your buffer car if you're going to run those tanker trains. Yeah, the FRA allows only one buffer car. When building a model train layout, stop thinking just about the tracks and what industries can I have my model railroads serve, and start thinking a little bit further away, because some of the places I'm going to show you are about a mile from railroad tracks, and they're cool places that you can model. When do you see people modeling enough farms or colleges? Literally from the top window of this college, you can see the Norfolk Southern tracks. But it's something that people wouldn't think to model. They're all only modeling like industries, and you're forgetting there's people, and there's towns, and there's colleges. Now going back to the model train layout, here's what I'm doing. Right now, I'm focusing on this Greensburg scene for my layout. And so what I'm doing is I'm looking at the area that I'm modeling. And I'm not going to capture every single building and every single road and parking lot in detail. But I flew the drone to kind of show you, like, this is Greensburg. And it's going to be one of the areas that I'm working on. So here is my and scale layout right now. The focus is on Amtrak, and this is going to be the Greensburg area. And originally I was using the inclines to have the town kind of sloped. I'm changing all of that. I am using Unitrack in most places. Now the problem with Unitrack, especially back here, it's so shiny. And I wasn't going to ballast it because you're really not going to see it from far away. But I just took some water and some acrylics and I'm just toning down that shininess just with like a black brown mixture. And then for the backdrop, it's like I wanted to bring some life to it and add something. So I scraped away some of the scenery material. Love my shop vac. And just simple dollar acrylics on top of foam. I love using foam. It's easy to paint. So just this little area back here. I'm painting a parking lot. And you'll see why in a second. So once this dries, it doesn't have to be perfect because it's from pretty far away. About a mile from the tracks is Brady's train outlet. It's a great hobby store. And I have a... I love this. My friend, the Pittsburgh train fanatic, he makes these. And this is an N scale. He's got these in all scales. Look at that. It's probably about a half inch, maybe about an inch thick. But perfect because now it's got some depth and it's a background and it kind of brings that whole scene to life. And even though it's a mile from the tracks, it's still Greensburg. So a few years ago in the summer, I caught Amtrak coming into the Greensburg station. And I'm modeling basically like this time of the year. And I'm just going to capture the elements of this scene. It's not going to be identical. It's not going to be exact. I'm going to make it filled with trees. Right now, I just finished ballasting the mainline tracks that are up close. Did some work on the bridge. And I'm changing the town up a little bit. And just doing a run through with my Amtrak to kind of show you how the scene's starting to come along. Look at the depth of the background now. There's going to be more to it. And so, yeah, the purpose of this video is to show you find areas that you find interesting. Just start with that. Give it some depth. Add signature stuff, even if they're a mile away from the tracks. So I got more really cool stuff in about a minute. All right, so wait till you see what's coming up. All right, so when you can't fly on the one side of the river because there's nowhere to park, you go on the other side of the river. Yeah, it's challenging flying over a river. This is over the Ohio River. I left from, I think it's called Stoops Ferry, like DeShields. I flew over the Ohio River to Leedsdale. Because I passed this on my side of the river with CSX, but on the other side is Norfolk Southern. There was nowhere to park. And look at this. This is all coming up in a future video. I love this kind of stuff. Do you guys like this stuff? Because too bad, you're going to see it in the next video. This is interesting, huh? When you think of coal, too many people think of, oh, we got to do mountains and we got to do coal mines. We got to do power plants. No, this is one of my favorite type of things to talk about. It is rail to river. And we're going to cover that in probably the next video, or at least the next couple videos, whatever. So here's what you got to do. You got to subscribe to my channel, DJ's Trains. Click on the bell icon to be notified when the video comes out. And yeah, go back and watch the older videos because I show you how to build these retaining walls and stuff. There's a lot of good stuff coming. So thank you guys. I appreciate all your support. And I'll talk to you really soon.